observers in the West African sub-region have raised concerns over fake news on social media and are urging governments to take action to stem the tide. Some nations have already been forced to suspend various social media companies in an effort to deal with the matter. Speaking at a two-day workshop on the challenge of misinformation, chairperson of the West African Election Observers Network, James Lahai, called for action.
The issue of misinformation, I normally refer to it as lying. Lying to the people, moving away from the truth. And this information, taking the truth and trying to twist it to throw people into confusion, is on the increase. It's now a very, very, very big challenge that we must acknowledge and plan ourselves on strategies of how to combat it. There is also this issue of the courts in the elections. It is good that we are coming to share experiences from our various countries. But let me just give you a bit. After our 2018 elections in Sierra Leone, 10 members of parliament lost their seats as a result of petitions. That is normal. What probably is of concern is that by-elections were not conducted for the people to decide who should replace those members of parliament, but rather the court said those who came second should become members of parliament.
Director of Policy and Advocacy at the CDD, Dr. Kujasanti, says governments must find a fine balance between dealing with fake news and not stifling free speech.
I mean, you've already seen examples of government shutting down internet or, you know, social media platforms. But if you recall in my speech, I said that the challenge is really how we strike the balance. I think everybody recognizes both the threats but also the opportunities. If you think of it in economic terms, if you shut down Facebook, the number of people who have just generated businesses or rely on that platform to do their trading is huge. So the benefits are there, but the threats are also there. So how do we strike a balance? And that has to do with not just the government, but also the platform, those who control the platform, like social media, Facebook or WhatsApp, and having a discussion as to what should be the best kind of regulation to ensure that we don't not overwhelmed by the threats, and that we can take advantage of the opportunities.